Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk to you all about how my airline is hiring. So on July 15th at 12 p.m., applications will open up. So I'm going to put the link down below. All you have to do is click on the link. Make sure to click on the in-flight crew member section. At my airline, we don't call it flight attendants, we call it in-flight crew member. So try and get used to that. I don't know if this is excessive. If you guys think this is excessive, hit the like button, let me know. So my airline usually gets, I think last hiring process, they had over 70,000 applications come in. So a way for your application to stand out from others is to make sure that you have some customer service experience in there and some leadership experience, and some community service would also go a long way as well. So make sure you do that. If you're interested in joining the team and drinking the blue juice, click the link down below. And good luck. So now I'd like to talk to you all about some pros and cons with being a flight attendant or an in-flight crew member. All right, with that being said, I want to talk to you all about some pros and cons of being a flight attendant or an in-flight crew member, and my experience with my first month as a flight attendant here. So first off, of course, one of the biggest pros there is with being a flight attendant is that you have the ability to travel anywhere you want within the country. Your first year is definitely the toughest, so this is gonna be a con. You're on reserve for a majority of it. It could be over a year too. I'm not sure how other airlines do it. I've heard other airlines do like 1 month with a schedule and then 1 month on reserve. But at my airline, you're basically on year reserve for the whole year, which means you're on call. You're either on home standby or airport standby. So it could be tough because you could literally be on your last hour of home standby and then called for like a 3 or 4 day trip. So it can be a little stressful at times, but this isn't one of those like jump into this career and expect like the craziest pay, because the pay isn't the greatest your first year either, because like I said, you're on reserve. So if you're planning to apply for this job because the pay per hour is good, you should probably look elsewhere, because you're not gonna get the hours you want your first year. Basically, this job is set up that over time, when you gain seniority, you'll get your own line, and then you'll be able to bid for those trips that you want, like the 4 day layovers or the 4 day trips or the 3 day trips. So if you're in this for like the short run, just to get free flights out of it, it's not gonna be worth it, and you probably won't be able to pay your rent. So I don't recommend that if you're only in it for a year or two. So if you want to become a flight attendant, you have to look in the long term or have an end goal with being a flight attendant, maybe like working towards being a pilot. So again, another one of the pros is scheduling. So the flexibility that you have with like managing your schedule for the month is insane. So it's not your typical Monday to Friday, 9 to 5 job. It's, you could work 3 days, be on 3 days, off 1 day, on 3 days, off 1 day, or you can set your schedule up to be like 6 days on, 1 day off, 6 days on, 2 weeks off. And then not only that, like say there's a day that you're working that month and you're like, oh man, I don't really want to work that day. You don't have to call your boss like, hey, like I can't make it in, or like call out sick. You can literally click that date and check to see on the reserve schedule if you can switch it with another day that's one of your off days, and just move your schedule around that way. So that's one thing I really like about being a flight attendant as well. So with that being said, I want to talk to you all about my first month as a flight attendant. Now, my experience hasn't been the same as everybody else's experience. I think I've been pretty lucky this first month. So my first trip was on an E-190. So it was me and somebody else. We literally had a three-leg day. So we flew somewhere, flew back, flew somewhere, and flew back. And after that weekend, I got called for a four-day trip. And I ended up having a layover in San Francisco. I had a layover in Fort Lauderdale, and then I had another 23-hour layover in San Francisco. And they put you up in these nice hotels. Most of the time, sometimes they'll have breakfast provided, and then you get obviously per diem for being away from home, so you get paid per hour that you're away from home. And then the last 3 weeks, I've been lucky as well. I got three LAX layovers, so I got the layover in Los Angeles for 23 hours each weekend. And in between, I had some four-day legs trips, but other than that, I basically flown Mint this whole month, which is our first class. So I've had a really good experience this first month. I can't really speak for anybody else, but that could be your first month. You never know. A few things that you're probably gonna hate while being on reserve is, first off, your ringtone. My anxiety goes through the roof whenever I hear my phone start ringing and the ringtone goes off, because you think it's like crew services calling you to be like, hey, like, we got a trip for you. And funny story, like, I remember my first, when they first called me to tell me I had a 4-day trip, they called me and they're like, is this Chris Kellum? And like, I answered the phone, I was like, yes. Like, I felt like I was in like a scene of 007. They're like, we have a mission for you. And I was like, okay. Like, we got a 4-day pairing. You're gonna do a layover in San Francisco and Fort Lauderdale. And I was like, okay, hell yeah. But literally felt like I was in like a scene of 007. It's kind of cool. But yeah, with that, this is the video. Hope y'all enjoyed it. If so, give me a thumbs up.